Okay. Hello, I'm Lautaro Weber, and together with my partner Eliseo Bonet, we are going to tell you about the project that we have developed. To begin, we are going to give an introduction. Currently, the consumption of drinking water is very high. That is, people use more water than they need, and that is why we must act as quickly as possible. To solve it, we come up with two ways. The first is to use less drinking water, and for this is necessary to create awareness. And the second is to replace the use of drinking water with clean water in situations or activities that are not necessary. We can achieve this by providing clean water. The solution we choose is to develop a system called an integral pump turbine that combines the two solutions discussed above. To give you a better orientation of how the practical work is done, we show you the following map. In this, we will begin by explaining the importance of responsible water consumption, then the operation of the integral pump turbine system will be developed considering the characteristics of the river. Will we continue with the explanation of the filtering, transport, and storage of the structured water? And finally, the environmental impact that this project entails will be developed.
Okay, hello, my name is Eliseo, and I'm going to start by talking about the importance of the responsible water consumption. According to the World Health Organization, 50 liters of drinking water per person are necessary and sufficient to cover hygiene, health, and nutrition needs. However, there is a two-way problem related to this parameter worldwide: the low and high consumption of drinking water. In some places, people have to walk for more than half an hour to get water and only have access to 5 liters or less of drinking water per day. This is not even enough for the feeding tax. So the hygiene and health conditions are terrible. No? In contrast with this, there are other places where drinking water is a very easily accessible to, and it's worth it too much. For example, In the United States, the average of drinking water per person, only for domestic use is greater than 300 liters. For this reason, one of the most important sustainable development goals for global change is to achieve a global balance in the consumption of drinking water around the world. It was previously mentioned that to reduce the consumption of drinking water, it was necessary to replace it with clean water, that is, filtered water without the purification process. There are many activities in which the use of drinking water is not necessary, both in domestic and industrial environments. For example, the use of clean water is sufficient in most activities related to personal hygiene, like taking a shower or brushing teeth. And cleaning objects such as the car or floor, for example. In addition, industrially, it can be used in tasks like irrigation or, for example, cleaning in general terms.
Okay. First, before installing the system, we have to take into account the location where it will work. The integral pump turbine was designed to operate in any parts of the river near the Parana city. This section of the river is called the Middle Parana River. The characteristics of this section are a flow rate of 70 million liters per second, a flow velocity between 0.7 and 1.6 meters per second, and a sediment size of 300 microns. We will use flow and velocity to calculate pressures and the amount of water draw by the system, while sediment size will be used to search for filters. On the other hand, the operating principle of the system is simple. First, the turbine is responsible for absorbing the kinetic energy of the river, transforming it into mechanical energy, and transferring the movement directly to the pump. The latter converting transferred movement into pressure that will extract the water. All this is possible thanks to a mechanical shaft that joins both parts and transmit all the power. It's very important not to transform mechanical energy into electrical energy, since when we do this transforming, we have greater energy losses.
Well, in this section, we're going to calculate the diameter of the turbine. In this case, we consider the power necessary to raise the water to the storage tank, located at height of 20 meters from the pump turbine. We use this power formula that takes into account established parameters such as the speed of the river, the density of the water, and a constant of the turbine. And then we solve for the diameter. Okay? With this data extracted from the references, the result was a diameter of 56 centimeters. So we set a standardized diameter of 60 centimeters and recalculate the power. Finally, the required power will be 1 3/4 horsepower, and obviously the diameter will be 60 centimeters. Okay, this is the general diagram of the project. As you can see, the integral turbine pump is located in the current of the river, and the transport pipeline begins there. There are two different filtering processes. The first one is located before the water enters the turbine, and it is responsible for protecting the plates from the rival sediments. The other filter is in charge of leaving the water completely clean, ready for the use in the community. Then the transport pipe is made of steel due to its great resistance and its low cost. The first section has a diameter of 2 inches, and the second one has a diameter of only 1 inch. And last part, the tank of storage is made of polyethylene, and it is located 15 meters high. Its capacity is 25,000 liters. Okay, I finish.
Okay. Environmental impact plays a very important role when carrying out an engineering project, and that is why we cannot ignore it. To understand the environmental impact more easily, we are going to compare the impact of large hydroelectric plant and small-scale projects like ours. Acting under the same specifications. First, we have the danger for the fauna, because depending on the shape of the turbines, they can harm the fish. Then we have the floods. These are caused by the change generated by the dams in the river levels. And finally, pollution from emissions from electric generators favors global warming. As we can see from the table, a small-scale system like ours do not have any of these negative aspects, because they don't have a dam or generate electricity. Also, as the turbines are specially built, they don't harm the fauna. Then we can see the integral pump turbine doesn't produce a significant environmental impact.
Great. There are two principal topics to conclude this presentation. First, it should be noted that the integral turbine pump meets the objectives proposed at the beginning in terms of reducing the consumption of drinking water and providing clean water to the community. On the other hand, this project addresses the framework of the sustainable development objectives or sustainable development goals, developed in English too. It is a sustainable and inclusive machine that uses green energy and does not produce pollution effects. In this way, the community is helped and our future is taken care of. This one is a list of all the references that have been used to develop the paper. It can be seen from the report of the SDGs to a specific material for pumps and turbines. Well, with my partner, we want to take a minute to thank all the time that the English 2 teachers have dedicated during the year. It was a great experience for us, and we have acquired a lot of skills that will be very useful in the future. thank you very much for